you any minute, and I want all this put away and out of sight. Ah, indeed, there you are, ladies and gentlemen. Goodness me, you are managing to get about all the way in. Please, do look around and ask about anything you see.
Violet may cling to tradition, but she does so in the face of enormous and rapid change. Perhaps in our own uncertain world, we can see something of ourselves here. Violet possesses... is the product of a disappearing time, the Victorian age of rigid glass barriers and codes of behaviour.
I was only going to say this symbol is entitled to her appearance.
No, she isn't until she is married. Then her husband will tell her what her opinions are.
Oh, crap.
It is an era which comes alive again for Violet, with the sudden appearance at Downton of a Russian admirer from her youth, Prince Karagin.
This is amazing. You know each other, you met in St. Petersburg. We did.
Allow me to present Prince Karagin.
Earth would bring the dressing gong instead of me, and at the wrong time. I wonder where you got to. Do we have all the stragglers? And the individual who discovered the gong, or would they prefer to stay anonymous? Very well.
Did I hear the dressing gong, Mr. Carson? Oh, I see. Well, hello again, my lords, ladies and gentlemen. I do hope you have found everything of interest, both up here and in our more workaday setting downstairs.
I still find it most irregular that the staff should be gawked at like displays in an exhibition.
If I might have a word, Mr. Carson, please excuse us for a moment. I thought you might want to look at these.
Applications for positions here. I don't understand, there must be dozens.
Hundreds? Those are just the tip of the iceberg.
Some of these names look familiar. No. Promising? Absolutely not.
I see my life's work.
They don't live badly, you have to concede.
They live as they're supposed to live. It has its burdens and its benefits.
Testing times are coming for these estates of need. They've already arrived. And many great families will go to the war over the next few years.
Mary, can you hear me?
We see some troubles, you and I. Nothing worse than this.
Guilty.
Said I'd find you here. Well, ladies and gentlemen, I do so hope you've enjoyed your visit, both above and below stairs.
I do think you were talking to. Hello, everybody. How nice to welcome you here.
Lady Grantham and I are delighted to have been able to share some of Downton with you today.
Indeed, we are. Only I hope we haven't worn you out. I'm afraid there's more than enough to explore here. And the truth is, the place is so rich in stories.
And in memories, don't forget. Some sad, of course, there's no denying. But we could teach you a thing or two about romance and friendship, too. And above all, let's remember the laughter.
Are we talking about your mother?
It's true. It's very hard to think of Downton without thinking of dear Mama. She is, after all, at its core.
And so are you. And so are we all, in a way, family and servants. I like to think this is a household with strong foundations.
And never a dull moment, as my mother would say. Would you excuse us? We must change for dinner.
Rose, I leave you in charge of fun.
Gardner would have added a search for logic. We should not look for it among the English upper.
Perhaps, my lady, but the real question is, what would the staff do without the family?
Well, the truth is, the family and all you who serve it so well together make Downton what it is. I could no more imagine this place without Mrs. Hughes than I could without Mama.
Well, I've never been compared to the Dowager Countess before.
For all you know.
Before the conversation gets out of hand, I suggest we move along into the drawing room.
Very good, my lady.
It was wonderful of you all to come, but now do please excuse us.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
May I also bid you farewell?